Hello guys, welcome back with me, ChoCho2025. Today we're going to learn how to use ControlNet and SDXL. With ControlNet Union Promax model, we only need one model for 12 type of control. Of course, you could regulars DEXL ControlNet model. But if you use more than one type of preprocessor, using this will save you some VRAM. You could do preprocessor open pose depth, canny, linart, animal linart, ensaldi, scribble, head, softage, teed, segment, and normal. Of course, you can do any combination with more than one control net, and you need only to load one model instead of two, and that way saving VRAM. Okay, first thing first, we need to download the model. Click the Hugging Face link on video description. Go to Files and Version. There is two safe tensor file here. The Diffusion PyTorch model is the old version which handle only 10 preprocessor. So download the new one that is Diffusion PyTorch model Promax. Download by click the arrow down icon next to the file name. Save it in your ControlNet model. In Comfy, the default is comfy/model/ControlNet. In Automatic 1111 is in model/ControlNet. I suggest changing the name. In my case, I change it into XL Union Promax. Now let's go back to our regular ControlNet workflow that we created on how to use ControlNet in Comfy video, link on video description. Now in this workflow, I will change the checkpoint model into an XL model. In this case, I use DreamShaper XL Lightning model. Just by running this without changing the ControlNet model, you will get his error messages. Mat1 and Mat2 shapes cannot be multiplied in 52, 48, and 7-6-3-2. Now let's change the ControlNet model into ControlNet XL Union Promax. Just by simply running the workflow, we will get result now. Currently we use realistic linart preprocessor. Let's try use canny edge. Now without changing the ControlNet model, run the workflow, we still get good result since this model could handle 12 preprocessor. Now let's try open pose preprocessor, that is DWA pose estimator. Open pose is working. Now let's try depth anything. Depth is working too. Now let's try segment with one former Coco segmenter. It is working too. Now let's try use two preprocessor. In this case, we use segmenter and realistic linart. Here we connect the same ControlNet model to both apply ControlNet. Practically only make us load one ControlNet for two ControlNet model. It has really saved some VRAM for us. Of course, you could always use SD1.5 model to save VRAM and upscale it. But if you want to use DEXL model, this option always exists. Anyway guys, that's it for today's video. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and comment. See you again on the next episode. And have a nice day. Please subscribe.